Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I am with my sister.
Hey!
Her name's Caitlin, and we're gonna be filming a Q&A video. I did ask this morning, I uploaded a video this afternoon of like me saying that I'm gonna do a question video. Here it is. We're gonna answer questions. We also just put on like Snapchat and Instagram to ask us questions, so if we get any questions from there, we'll be definitely reading them at the end. But I'm just gonna go ahead and answer the question. Do you want to tell them a little bit about yourself? How old are you?
I'm 22.
I'm 22.
My birthday is in December. I'm pretty sweet.
Yeah,
she's I'm cool. A dental assisting student.
Awesome.
In Nanaimo.
Yeah, so she doesn't live near me. And why are you here?
I'm here because I'm going to a dental conference at the convention center here in Vancouver. And I'm here with a bunch of friends, so.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Well, we'll get right into the questions. Panya asked, how is the global makeup program going for you? It's going good. I really enjoy it. I'm in TV and film right now, and I'm like meh about it because I'm not really into TV and film or anything like that. I'm more into like the beauty makeup and fashion, I think. And like obviously airbrushing. I love airbrushing. But you also went to the you went to Blanche Personnel as well.
Yeah.
Do you want to tell them about that?
I went to Blanche and did a professional hairdressing program in 2012. We did a lot of really cool stuff. My favorite part was probably the bridal outfit.
Yeah.
It was pretty cool. It was fun.
Overall, good experience?
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Yeah. Okay, so then we're going to go to Chris. Ask, hi PG, I subscribed to you about 2 weeks ago. I came across you on Brie Kelly's channel. Do you believe in ghosts? And then I love your channel, you're really pretty. Thanks. Do you believe in ghosts?
I hate ghosts.
Okay. So you believe in ghosts? Like,
yeah.
I don't believe in
like,
ghosts. I believe in spirits.
Okay, so I have this cat and her name is Zoe and she's literally my child. And she will sit there on my kitchen counter and stare at stuff, and I swear there's ghosts living in my apartment.
Do you believe in ghosts or like spirits? Because ghosts, I find that like they're like, you know, like the white little ghosts. I don't believe in things like that. I believe in like spirits, not like that humans can go into. Like when a person dies, I don't believe that they can haunt them. I believe that like there's like demonic spirits and then humans. Like, I think that they have no part of, like, any, like, human whatsoever. That's what I believe in. I don't believe in ghosts, no. I believe in spirits, yes. They're different things. Okay. So you believe in
ghosts.
Okay.
Anything that can, like, haunt your house, like, there's stuff that may be in there.
And then also Sarah, like, commented on that and was like, I'm curious to know about this, too. Does she believe in ghosts and has she ever had any paranormal experiences? I've made a video about, well, with Brie, about, like, paranormal experience, so I can link that down below. I've had a couple, but, not as many as Brie, obviously. Have you had any experiences?
No.
No?
No.
Okay,
so, like, when I used to live in Vancouver, we would go to Fort Langley, and there's this super old haunted house, and, yeah, we would get scared.
Really?
Yeah,
I didn't know about that. I didn't never heard about that.
But there's one. Like, we left one girl there once just because we thought it was funny, but it was actually terrifying.
Oh my god, okay, this one paranormal experience. It was like in the old house, like old house.
Like a Maryland house.
Yeah, Maryland house. This one time I was at nighttime and I thought you were like walking the stairs. Like it was like you, but you had like long hair, like longer hair, and like I followed you thinking it was you down the stairs, and I went downstairs and there was nothing.
That's true.
I know. It was really scary actually. Like I didn't really realize that it was like something until like this year. And then the snake whisperer said, please advice to Pleasure on how to enhance hazel green eyes and make them look more green. Well, if you want to bring out green, you're gonna go like on
purple.
Is that what you think it is?
Yeah, that's my opinion.
Purple. I think reds. Like whenever I wear red eyeshadow, I feel like my green, like really, like green in my eyes really stick out. It's like color wheel. I find if you go across, like they're like combo colors. Yeah, so I think red or like any warm eyeshadows would ruin the green. If you could not have a career in beauty industry, what do you think you'd end up doing? This is from Sarah. Well, I don't think so. I think I'd probably be in like criminology or something like that. And like, so
I don't know. I did dental.
Instead of hair.
Beauty.
And Brie was like, you're making this fucking dope today. Love you. Love, love, love you. What are some piercings slash tattoos that you guys want to get in the future?
Well, actually, I want to go get my nose pierced this weekend. I have one side, but I want to go get the other.
You want to get the other one done?
Yeah, maybe we'll make a YouTube bit about it.
Oh my god, I'm so excited. And any pierced tattoos?
I want to get the one on my side covered up with something else.
The one on your side?
The really ugly feather.
That's all
about us. So I have this feather that I got, and it was kind of a mistake.
Why?
Because it was like spontaneous, and I just
and it has like color. It has like our family's favorite colors in it.
Yeah, but I kind of want to get covered up with something more cool.
Oh, okay.
Like something like bigger and like prettier, like a pineapple.
Good idea.
Just kidding.
It's a good idea. And then for me, piercings, I kind of want to get my web done, which is like,
oh my god, I want to get that
underneath your tongue. Yeah, I want to get that really done really bad.
Apparently it doesn't hurt.
Yeah, I don't think it would. And tattoo-wise, I want to get my sleeve done, because I just got this one. Little kitty cat.
We both have cat tattoos.
Yeah, I want to get the backs of my arms done in the future, and then I want to build my like sleeve up. I'm probably gonna build down and then I'm gonna build up. I don't know. But I'm like, I want my fingers on too, but I'm not really sure about that yet. I don't know. I'm really indecisive about my fingers because I want them all done, but then I'm like, eh. And what's the craziest thing you guys have done together that your parents never found out about?
We've ever done together? I don't know, I was in the bathtub once with Paige. And she squatted up and pissed in my mouth. She literally peed in my mouth. That happened. That's probably the craziest thing.
Oh my god.
Slash most disgusting.
How old are we?
We were probably like...
I was probably like 5.
5 and 7. Like, she literally got like in the crab position and like, pissed in my mouth.
Slash the creep. That's pretty funny.
I don't know, we never really did much.
No, we didn't really like each other.
We hated each other.
Until like now.
Yeah, right? I still don't really
like that. I like you though. No, mom always tells me that you talk about me. You're like, can you tell me all this stuff? I'm so excited. And then Tamara was like, what's your favorite part of living in Vancouver so far, besides school?
What was your favorite part?
I like the people here. People here are really nice, and work is like my fave ever. And like just like how much activity there is here, like there's so much opportunity to like grow, and like the nightlife is like insane. Not that I go out a lot, but like if you want to,
it's pretty fun.
It's fun. Yeah.
And there's lots of places to like adventure
and like eat.
Like Capilano Suspension Bridge.
I haven't gone yet.
The Gross Grind.
Yeah. And then you also said, what's your favorite thing to cook for dinner?
Pizza. Hands down. I love cooking pizza.
Love you.
Chicken strips.
I like, yeah, like stir fries, and I like to cook pancakes for dinner sometimes. It's like one of my favorite things to do. Paleo pancakes, of course.
I just like shit food.
How is the cost of living in Vancouver? I'm attending the University of Saskatchewan and I was thinking of moving to Vancouver this coming September. I eventually would love to apply to the Global Makeup Artistry Program. Any advice as what to expect? What do you think you'll be doing after you complete the program? And that's from Tyler George. It's expensive here, like super expensive.
Super expensive.
Like it's insane. Anything, if you want to live anywhere, I'd recommend getting roommates. Yeah, it's expensive. The Global Makeup is amazing. There's a lot of like well-educated teachers that teach you, and they are like, they've been in the industry for a long time, which like it really helps. It's fun. It's just like, it is a lot of money. It's a full commitment, and you got to make sure that you're ready for it, because I've had like two people drop out of my class, and I'm like, that's insane because it's so much money here. It's a lot. It's a big commitment. What to expect though? Like when you moved to Vancouver, like
it's kind of a newsflash. Like it's like holy, like there's a lot out there.
Yeah, and you gotta like, it's like
you gotta find yourself.
Yeah. I've definitely found myself when I lived here.
Yeah,
it's insane. Like
I agree.
I was back when I was like kind of unstable. I don't think I could ever live here. Like there's so much going on. You gotta like do a lot of things, like have a job and like a lot of work. Living like on your own is a lot of work if you're not living on your own. I don't know. Yeah. And Kristen was like, "Hey girl, any advice on how to start the paleo diet and where to shop? I've been curious about it since we spoke when you're over, but never got around to asking you." Okay, so I would start out slow and like cut out, say, dairy mostly. I'd cut out dairy first and gluten. And then you can get down to like breaking it down even more. If you guys don't know, like I do paleo and it's like no dairy, no gluten, no grains, no legumes, no lentils, no sugar, no salt, no processed food. No
literally gluten. Everything that I eat, she doesn't.
Pretty much.
I'm like a vacuum. I love
you're
McDonald's.
Doing good. Oh my gosh.
I eat McDonald's probably like 3 times a week.
No you don't. Don't tell me that.
Love it. Can't go wrong with the cheeseburger.
What's the McGriddle? Is that like pancakes?
Ew. Ugh. Paige, one time when she was working at Shoppers in Kelm River, got in my car and ordered McDonald's pancakes. And I literally was driving
people's
her.
People's
Begmar.
People.
And I literally was gagging during the drive. It smelled so bad. I can't do fast food breakfast. It's like a huge no-go.
What? The bagel bells from Tim Hortons are good. I remember getting those when I was like back on. So anyways, yeah, I'd start out slow. Where to shop is anything like I would say for you, like, well, in Canberra River. What's that place called?
Healthy Way.
Healthy Way. I always, like, whenever I go visiting or when I used to live there, I'd always shop at Healthy Way. Save on Foods is really good to get, like, organic food. I would start with organic. 50s, yeah, 50s is really good. 50s is super good. Organic, like, you gotta be, like, there's a bunch of like ways you can search like the dirty, clean, 17 cut or 12, whatever it is. Like any vegetable that's underground or in a peel, you can get non-organic. And then anything like say like broccoli, I'd get organic because you don't want all those like pesticide things on it. Yeah. But anything like a banana, you can get like non-organic. It's fine. And, like, avocados,
but even
like,
in the summertime, like heading up to Black Creek, like there's so many farms that often like you can just drive off the highway and it's like all fresh fruit,
and like fresh eggs.
Grown. Yeah, eggs always. You can get them like a dozen eggs for like $4.
And so nice, and like chickens and stuff. Like, and also like picking out the best meat possible for you, like ones that are not like just like on sale because it's a couple days old. Like get the ones that are like more organic and like grass-fed if you can find that, like buying them from like butcheries and stuff like that are really good because like your meat, like what the animal eats on the farm is what you eat, so you want to eat the most cleanest meat there possible. And I know it's gonna be really, really expensive, like it's insanely expensive, but it's definitely worth it in the long run for sure. I think that's it. So I want to thank everyone for submitting questions to me. And I want to thank you so much for joining me.
It's so nice to be here. Thanks.
And if you guys like these videos, definitely like hit the thumbs up button and subscribe if you're not already to see more videos. And I'll see you guys really shortly in my next video. Bye.